Hi, I'm Saito Katsunori, a professional photographer. Today, I'll be showing you how to adjust brightness and colors individually using the LCH tool in Nikon's NX Studio. Here's a picture of tulips taken from a low angle. Because they're backlit, the picture is dark overall, and the tulip blossoms aren't vivid enough. So, let's try adjusting this picture of tulips using the LCH tool. Click Lightness, Chroma, and Hue Adjustment in the Adjustments palette, and then the LCH tool. Clicking here displays a pull-down menu where you can choose from the Chroma, Hue, Color Lightness, and Master Lightness channels and make individual adjustments to each one. This time, let's try using Master Lightness to make the picture brighter overall. You can edit this tone curve directly if you like. Or, down here, where we have Gamma, you can make adjustments using this slider. This time, let's try making the picture brighter with the Gamma slider. The dark areas are now brighter. Next, the sky. Let's try making the colors in this area deeper and more vivid. Here, we'll use Color Lightness. Click Color Lightness, and then the eyedropper icon here. And then click a spot in a blue part of the sky. That adds a point to this color lightness curve like this. We can use the mouse to drag this point up for added brightness or down to make things darker. Here the sky is too bright, so we'll drag this point down. Then, we'll use this slider at the bottom to increase the range of colors affected and darken the whole sky. Next, I'll use Chroma to make the colors of the sky more vivid. As before, we'll sample a spot in a blue part of the sky with this eyedropper. And as before, that adds a point to the Chroma curve like this. We can use the mouse to drag this point up to make colors more vivid or down to make them less intense. Let's try it and see. If I drag the point up, you can see that the colors have changed slightly. I can then use this width slider to increase the range of the effect so the whole sky is more vivid, like this. Finally, the red parts of the tulip blossoms are kind of blah, don't you think? Let's try repeating the process to make the colors in this area more vivid. Using the eyedropper, first, click in the red area of the tulips to add a point to the chroma curve. Drag the point up and increase the width to make the red parts of the tulip blossoms more vivid, like this. Okay, let's compare it with how it looked before. We can see the unedited version by unchecking this box. Not only are the colors more vivid, but the dark areas are brighter. This is how you can recover a picture's lost brilliance. Moving on, let's try editing another picture using the LCH tool. This is a photo of the Tokyo Bay area, where high-rises abound. It's a bit low contrast overall, plus the background is lacking in warm colors. I feel it lacks a certain something, although as a twilight scene it is very pretty as well. So first, I want to try adjusting contrast. The tool I'll use is Master Lightness. To increase contrast, I'll shape the tone curve in an S. First, I'll push highlights up a little. Then pull shadows down a little. That increases the difference between light and dark, enhancing contrast. Next, to adjust the warm colors where the sun is setting in the background, we'll use Chroma. We'll click a spot somewhere in the red part of the sky with the eyedropper to add a point for the sampled spot to the Chroma curve. Finally, let's drag this bit up and use the slider to increase the width. This gives us a more colorful sunset. Let's compare it with how it looked before. The LCH tool has turned a twilight scene that felt less than satisfactory into one that pops. Okay, what do you think? With the LCH tool, we can quickly and easily make these kinds of targeted adjustments to color and brightness.